Hello everyone. In the last video, we have seen the oxidation and reduction reaction. So in this video, we are going to see the effects of oxidation which we face in our day-to-day life. Now there are two main effects of oxidation, which are corrosion and rancidity. So we are going to see these effects one by one in detail. So the first effect is corrosion. Now corrosion can be simply defined as the oxidation of metal when it is exposed to air. Now this oxide layer is called as corrode. You must have seen iron getting red coating after some time when it is kept in air. So this red coating is nothing but iron oxide, and this is due to oxidation of iron. So you can see the oxidation of iron, silver getting a black coating, or copper getting a green coating is also example of corrosion. Now this corrosion is due to the exposure of the metals to the oxygen. Now corrosion is also not good for metals because it causes wastage. So there are many methods to prevent this corrosion, like oiling, coating, painting and greasing. These were very few. We are going to see these methods in detail in our next chapter, which is metals and non-metals. So for now, let's discuss the second effect of oxidation, which is rancidity. Now, have you ever wondered why you keep your cooked food in the fridge? So the answer is you keep your food in the fridge so as to prevent the food from rancidity. Now, rancidity is a process which affects the food materials. The fats and the oil get oxidized, and hence the food material gets rancid, creating a foul smell and also change in taste. It makes the food unfit for the consumption. We can protect the food from rancidity by keeping it in low temperatures, or oiling it, or keeping it in airtight containers. But one question should strike your mind right now. Why the potato chips which are kept in our packets do not get rancid? So the again answer is, the packet is flushed with nitrogen gas. What does this nitrogen does? This nitrogen cuts the supply of oxygen which reaches to the potato chips, and hence protecting the potato chips from getting rancid. So we have seen in this chapter what are the chemical reactions and how we can write these chemical reactions in the form of equations. We have also learned how to balance these equations. At last, we have seen the oxidation and reduction reaction and also the effects of oxidation, which is corrosion and rancidity. So, we have learned all the concepts in this chapter, but do check your understanding by taking up our test.